Good morning, all of you. This is lesson number 1 and the chapter name is sentence. So today we will understand the sentence and its type. Okay, so first of all we will understand definition of a sentence. In simple words, a sentence is a group of words that expresses a complete thought. Here are some example of complete and incomplete thoughts. Okay, so in simple words, what is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words. Okay, so what is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words that expresses a complete thought. Okay, means it is what? It is a group of words that expresses what? That expresses a complete thought. Okay, so here are examples of complete as well as incomplete thoughts. Okay, so first of all we will understand examples of a sentence. So I have told you, what is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words, okay, that expresses a complete thought. Okay, means a group of words which expresses a complete thought, complete meaning on its own, then it will be termed as a sentence. Okay, he opened the door. He opened the door is what? Is a group of words which is expressing a complete thought and a complete meaning. That is why it will be termed as a sentence. Come in, please. In this sentence, group of words is present, right? And most important thing is that it is expressing a complete thought. So that is why it will be termed as a sentence. Do you like coffee? Is again group of words which is expressing a complete thought and a complete meaning. That do you like coffee? So that is why it will be termed as a sentence. Okay, so in all these sentences you can see that group of words is present there, and most important thing is that it is expressing a complete thought and a complete meaning. So that is why it will be termed as a sentence. Okay, now each sentence expresses a complete thought. Okay, now we will understand not a complete sentence. Okay, so people who work hard. So people who work hard is group of words, obviously you can see, but the thing is that it is not expressing a complete thought and neither it is providing a complete meaning. So that is why it is not a complete sentence. Okay, a fast moving animal. Okay, so it is also group of words, but it is not providing a complete meaning or a complete thought. So that is why it will be termed as not a complete sentence. Beautiful kites in the sky. So beautiful kites in the sky is again group of words, but most important thing is that it is not expressing a complete thought. It is not providing a complete meaning. So that is why it will be not termed as a sentence. It is a incomplete sentence. Okay, now the thing which you have to remember is that each group of words does not expresses a complete thought. Okay, so it is not necessary, it is not mandatory that each group of words will express a complete thought. Okay, example, you can see people who work hard, a fast moving animal, beautiful kites in the sky. So these are example of a not a complete sentence, and as you can see that each group of words does not expresses a complete thought. Okay, so now we will understand a sentence usually contains two elements. So what are those two elements that a sentence contains. Okay, so a sentence usually contains two elements, that is a subject and a predicate. So first of all, we will understand definition of a subject. So what is a subject all about? A subject which tells us who or what the sentence is about. So what is a subject? A subject is something which tells us who or what the sentence is about. For example, Ram is a good boy. So in this sentence, as you can see, that we are talking about Ram. So the sentence is about Ram. So Ram will be the subject of the sentence. Okay, so a subject is what? A subject is something which tells us who or what the sentence is about. So now we will understand a predicate. A predicate is what? A predicate is something which tells us something about the subject. Okay, a predicate is what? It tells us something about the subject. For example, Ram is a good boy. So is a good boy will be what? It will be the predicate of the sentence. Why it will be the predicate of the sentence? Because it is telling us something about the subject Ram. Okay, so that is why it will be termed as predicate of the sentence. Hope you have understand subject and predicate properly. So what is a subject? A subject which tells us who or what the sentence is about, and a predicate is something which tells us something about the subject. Okay, so for the better understanding, we will take some examples. Now, you speak English. Okay, so as you can see here, that duple words is present in this sentence, right? You speak English. So this is what? This is a sentence. Why it is a sentence? Because it is providing a complete thought as well as a complete meaning. So that is why it will be termed as a complete sentence. Now you have to identify what is the subject of the sentence and what is the predicate of the sentence. So you is the subject of the sentence, because in this sentence we are talking about you. You speak English, right? So we are talking about you, so that is why you will be the subject of the sentence. Okay, now speak English is what? It is predicate, because it is providing more information about subject. Okay, so you speak English. So speak English will be what? Will be predicate. Okay, and you is what? You is the subject. Ram and Tara speak English when they are working. As you can see, that in this sentence, group of words is present, and most important thing is that it is expressing a complete thought or a complete meaning towards the sentence. Okay, so that is why it will be termed as a complete sentence. Now you have to identify what is the subject and what is the predicate. So a subject is what? The sentence all about is what? The sentence is all about Ram and Tara. So Ram and Tara will be the subject of the sentence, and when they speak English, when they are working. So this will be what? This will be termed as predicate, because it is telling something about the subject. Okay, obey your parents. Obey your parents is what? Predicate. In this sentence, subject is hidden. So, you is what? You is the subject of the sentence that is hidden. So, you should obey your parents. You will be the subject which is hidden and your parents is what is predicate. Okay? Hope you have understand the topic clearly. Thank you.